I'm Dr. Barry Ramo, and this is my colleague, Miss Marissa Mays. You know her as the co-anchor on Action 7 News More in the Morning. But Marissa is also a nurse. Do you know what to do if someone suddenly collapsed or had difficulty with a choking episode and couldn't breathe? Would you know what to do if you were having a heart attack or someone else was having a heart attack? Well, we're going to teach you that. We're going to give you a crash course in saving a life.
Every day we hear about somebody who has suddenly collapsed from a cardiac arrest and dies. Sometimes it's somebody that we know, or it may even be a family member. Sudden cardiac arrest happens about 400,000 times a year in this country. Some of those deaths could have been prevented if someone knew CPR.
Marissa, I often say that these hearts are really too good to die. In fact, if you wait for the paramedics to come, it's too late. As good as our paramedics are, wasting all that time not providing a circulation makes virtually no chance for someone to survive. You know, in the past, that CPR was extremely complicated. You had to remember the number of breaths, the number of pumps. Well, now everything has changed, and we're going to show you how to do the new CPR.
And this new CPR requires just two things. When somebody suddenly collapses, the first thing you do is call 911. Then you begin chest compressions hard and fast.
When someone suddenly collapses in front of you, first you have to establish that they're unconscious. You do that by shaking and shouting.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
You need to call 911 as quickly as possible. Now, if you're by yourself, you have to call 911. But if not, order someone else to call 911 right away.
Everybody is nervous when they call 911, but the operators can really help you if you let them lead you through the questions. They know what they need to do and to send the right kind of help. Now, sometimes people get so excited, they forget to tell where they are, and they hang up.
Okay, stay on the line. Do not hang up. What's your address?
4601 Burton Avenue. Okay, can I put this? I'm going to put it on speakerphone.
Okay, I'm dispatching the paramedics now.
Let the 911 operator talk you through all of the questions and don't hang up too quickly. Wait until they say it's okay. Send your bystander outside to wait for the paramedics to arrive. That way, when they come, they'll know exactly where to go. Okay, let's go through the entire scenario of what it means to do the new CPR.
When you see somebody collapse, it's hard to believe that it's real. But that's where the reflex action you learned today comes into play.
In that reenactment, we showed you the two elements of the new CPR after you've established the victim is unresponsive. First, calling 911, staying on the line, and following their directions. And now we'll show you the second component of the new CPR. Chest compressions only, hard and fast in the middle of the chest.
As you approach the person from the side, check for signs of life. Shake and shout. Establish responsiveness. Rub the sternum if necessary. Open the shirt. Place your palms mid-sternum between the nipple line. Hand over palm. Elbows locked. Shoulders over your hands. Compressing the chest. 1 1/2 to 2 inches. As you're doing CPR, continue to look for signs of life. Looking for movement, looking for chest rise, and listening to see if you can hear the person breathing. But continuing CPR. Continue CPR hard and fast. 100 times per minute. This can be very tiring. If you have somebody to switch off with you, take advantage of that and have another person assist you. The clicking of the mannequin indicates that I'm doing proper compressions, that I am compressing the chest 1 1/2 to 2 inches. As you compress the chest, let it recoil all the way up. Remember, keep your elbows locked, your shoulders over your palms, and let your body weight compress the chest. Do not stop CPR. Continue compressions until paramedics have arrived.
Take a look at our logo for Project Heart Start. It has three components. The first two you've just learned. You call 911 and you do chest compressions hard and fast.
And the third component is the lightning bolt. That represents the shock that is delivered to the heart in order to restore the rhythm back to normal. Now, you've seen this done hundreds of times on TV, and I do it in the coronary care unit or in the emergency room not infrequently. But now there is a new way which involves you, and we're going to show you how it's done.
Now, we know that there's always going to be a delay between the time that you call 911 and when the paramedics arrive. And during that time, you have to keep pumping.
Well, you've probably noticed these signs. They're virtually everywhere in airports, businesses, restaurants. These are lifesavers. They're called AEDs, automated external defibrillators. And knowing how to use those can really cut the time and save lives.
The AED can cut precious minutes from the time delay that occurs between when the victim collapses and their heart is shocked.
No, I don't remember anything happening at all. They said that I said that I feel weird, and then I went out.
Nicholas wouldn't remember because while at school, he had a sudden cardiac arrest, and his teacher, Mary Ann Evans, was first on the scene.
Two kids came in running and said, there's an emergency next door, we need you. Didn't have a pulse, could not get a pulse. Put my cheek down next to him, couldn't feel any kind of breathing, and I went straight to the compressions.
Then after 15 minutes of chest compressions, another teacher brought the AED to Nicholas and shocked his heart back to normal. The student's teacher shocked his heart back to normal using the AED. She saved his life. Now let's look at how that AED works. This is what an AED looks like, and if there's one around, go ahead and use it, even if you've never been trained. You open the case, and sometimes the AED goes on automatically, but in this case, you push the green button and let the AED do the talking.
Apply pads to patient's bare chest. Plug in pad's connector next to flashing light. Analyzing heart rhythm. Do not touch the patient. Shock advised. Charging. Stay clear of patient. Deliver shock now. Press the orange button now. Shock delivered. If needed, begin CPR.
The AEDs should be in every public place. Now, if you work in a place that does not have one, make sure that they get one and employees are trained on them. Know where it's kept and be ready because you can never tell when a cardiac arrest will happen. Talk to your boss, or if you're the boss, buy one and get trained. The AED should be as common as a fire extinguisher.
Marissa, there are many possible causes for a cardiac arrest, but one of the most common causes is a heart attack. Often people don't recognize the fact that if you delay, there's a good chance you'll never make it to the hospital. We estimate that about 50% of the people who have heart attacks die before they get to the hospital.
Wow. Well, just as you couldn't believe that somebody you were watching was suffering a sudden cardiac arrest, most people don't want to believe that they're actually having a heart attack. They want to call it something else.
5 years ago, at the age of 46, I was exercising and started to experience some heart symptoms. Basically, chest pain and sort of an ache in my left elbow. And I ignored it for a few weeks, like a lot of women do.
The symptoms of a heart attack aren't always so easy to tell. It's not necessarily an elephant sitting on your chest.
And finally called my doc, and she said it's probably acid indigestion.
It might be a burning, aching, or squeezing sensation. Sometimes it feels like indigestion. Sometimes you don't have pain at all, but rather a feeling of severe shortness of breath and sweating.
I thought I was getting the flu, but that wasn't the case, I don't think.
Now, if that discomfort lasts for more than 10 minutes, do not mess around.
Call 911 and take 2 aspirin. Do not drive yourself to the hospital unless there is no choice.
If you call 911, you are summoning a coronary care unit. That means that if you or someone you called the rescue for develops a cardiac arrest, that heart rhythm can be converted back to normal by the paramedics in just seconds. Well, now you've learned the life-saving technique of hands-only CPR, and you've learned what to do if you or someone else thinks they're having a heart attack. But now we're going to teach you one other important life-saving technique, and that's how to deal with a choking victim.
Your airway can become blocked for a number of reasons, but the most common cause is choking on food or some sort of foreign body. Sudden airway obstruction from any cause can be a life-threatening emergency. Now, if your airway is completely blocked, you're not going to be able to make any sound at all. So that means that you should quickly apply a chest thrust called the Heimlich maneuver. Here's how it's done.
A person with an obstructed airway can't talk or even cough. Ask them if they can breathe. If they can't, wrap your arms around their upper waist, placing the fist of your hand under their breastbone. Then thrust upward and inward repeatedly until the food or the object is dislodged. If this doesn't work, begin CPR and call 911. Well, congratulations. You've just completed a crash course in saving a life. The information you learned today is not only going to change your life, but changes many other people's lives in the future. If you want to learn more about CPR, I suggest you take a 4-hour course. That'll teach you about dealing with infant problems and drowning victims.
You can also purchase a kit for your friends and family to practice on. We also want you to keep in mind that doing nothing when somebody collapses and is unresponsive is simply not an option. You've got to act quickly. Call 911 and begin CPR. And remember that you can always ask if there's an AED available.
Have a very healthy day.
Yo, yo, I'm Dr. Ray Moe. There's a new CPR you got to know. Don't let the time get past. Call 911 and pump hard and fast. No more counting, no more breaths. Keep on pumping till you see the EMS.
Call 911.
So when someone goes down, don't mess around. Call 911 and pump hard and fast.